use, Graves. We know of your deeds. No longer will we tolerate these malevolent acts. There is only one fate for thee. As it is written, thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. This makes it clear what we must do.
Yeah!
To the gallows, Graves!
Domine me, magnus protegas me ab his malis. De mihi potestatum notis opus superesse!
Sunflower, Kansas. What a cliche.
Well, you just have to get past the name and look at its personality. It's old and cute, like shabby chic.
Yeah, I pay $35,000 a year for shabby chic. Well, what's still way better than what people pay for out of state?
And at least we won't have to room with some weirdo.
But I have to room with the weirdo.
Shut up.
I'm just sad we can't spend our summer out here.
Yeah, it sucks, but I really lucked out with this internship. And we have cute housing in this nice little town. So I know it's hard, but it will be worth it.
Yeah, I hope so. You know, I didn't think I'd have my own house until I was at least 30.
Well, we can decorate it all we want and have parties with people over and no rules.
Okay, that does sound fun. Oh, look, an old diner, a cheap boutique, and oh, you'll like this one, a bookstore for nerds like you.
Don't make fun of me. That's really exciting.
It looks like the Grim Reaper's summer home. Can't wait to check that one out.
The house will be on your next left.
Welcome to Halloween Town.
I mean, we got it for cheap. Of course it's gonna need some fixing up.
Right. I'll try to keep an open mind.
Look at all the stuff. We could go into the antiquing business.
It came completely furnished. At least we have everything we need.
Looks like someone's grandma died in here and left everything they had.
We just need to clean it up a bit, and then it'll be like living in some castle or something.
Yes, Your Royal Highness.
I'm gonna grab some more boxes.
I'll dust some of the stuff off.
I think this is the last of it.
Awesome, let's start unpacking.
Let's do the kitchen first, because these are my mom's plates and I cannot risk them getting broken.
Right.
What's that?
Oh, this? Just something I found.
Kinda creepy.
I don't know, maybe.
So what are you doing with it?
I wasn't doing anything.
Okay.
It's just some old grandma's where she probably writes grocery lists and gossips about her friends.
What's that? Is this from that book?
No. Yes, look, it's a diary, Rachel. People don't like other people going through their diary.
Then why do you still have it?
If it was so important to them, why did they take it when they left?
I don't know.
Look, I won't touch it. I won't touch anything else in this house. Is that better?
It just makes me nervous, Delilah.
I've known you forever, Rachel. There aren't many things that don't make you nervous.
Did you already unpack the plates?
I don't think so.
Well then, can you help me look for them? They can't have just disappeared.
Did you leave them in the car?
No, I took everything out of the car.
Well then, I don't know.
They're my mom's plates.
I'm sure we'll find them. Just keep unpacking.
What? Delilah? Delilah.
What is it?
I thought you needed something.
What?
Why? You were calling me, I thought.
No, I wasn't.
Oh, okay.
Go to bed, Rachel.
Good night.
Make it quick, Rachel. We still have to get plates.
Got it.
Welcome to Magnum Opus Books. We have a 70% sale on nonfiction and biographies. Can I help you today?
No, I'm just looking.
Okay, cool. So you just moved here?
What?
I'm not a stalker or anything. It's just that it's a small town, and when people move in, you tend to notice. Which place is yours?
The one on Rose Hill with the big...
The big sycamore tree. Yeah. I'm James. My dad owns the bookstore. Are you and the other girl together?
Yeah, that's Delilah. We start college here in the fall.
Oh, yeah. Good old Sunflower State University.
I heard my name.
Yeah, this is James. I was just telling him about how we moved in.
Yeah, last night was our first night here.
Sleep well?
Not really. I kept hearing things.
Thought she was hearing things, Rachel. Don't say it like that.
It's just new house tutors, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go.
It was nice meeting you, James.
You too. And Rachel?
Yeah?
Be careful.
Why?
Huh?
Why do I need to be careful?
Oh, nothing.
What do you mean?
It is just like, be careful, drive safe, God bless, I wish you well, you know?
Okay, it was good to meet you, James.
It's our first home cooked meal together, Dee.
I can't do any more delivery pizza.
Maybe later this week we could clean some old stuff out of the house, you know, now that we've settled in.
I thought you didn't want to mess with any of it.
Well, we can't mess with it if it's out of the house.
Is it still scaring you?
I'm not scared.
I haven't touched that book since the day we moved in.
I've been hearing voices almost every single night.
You're just dreaming.
Delilah!
Going
to get more eggs. I'll see you later.
Can't buy clothes, nowhere to put them. Thank you.
Edward, hurry it up. We're gonna be late. Up all night reading again?
I swear I meant to go to sleep, Madison. I just can't put this book down. It's just so-
If you only worked half as hard in the orchard as you do reading your silly little stories, we wouldn't have to be pinching for little cents. If Father catches you slacking off like this, especially with the depression-
If I read enough books, I won't have to work in the orchard. I could go to university.
Don't start with this again, Edward. Just forget about your books and work like the rest of us. Now come on, get.
I forgot my canteen.
Edward, we can't be late again. Mr. Barnum won't have it.
Don't wait for me, I'll see you at the orchard. Madison? Madison! Is anybody over here?
It's you. Follow me. So, what can I do for you?
I need your help.
With what?
Well, nothing serious, but some weird things are happening. Like, I just have weird feelings about the house I moved into.
Wait. Why do you want to know about something so obscure?
Well, me and my friend, we found a book. A really strange book.
A freaky brown book, right?
Tell me what you know about it.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know anything about books.
Look, can you just point me in the right direction?
I don't know what you're talking about. My tongue must have slipped. I'm serious! I don't want to hear anything about any freaky brown book, and I don't want to hear about the thing ever again.
It's doing something to me.
Sorry. I'm sorry. It's just that book is bad news. Very bad news. And the fact that you touched it, even worse.
Look, it's a freaky book, but it can't actually do anything. It's just a book.
No, you don't understand. This book is old. I'm talking Salem witch trials old, maybe more. It's been around for so long, and anyone that knows anything about it knows that death and misfortune follow it everywhere. It doesn't have a name, not a written one anyway. And we don't know where it came from. But we sure know what it does.
Talk to people?
No. No. It takes them. Steals them, kills them, whatever you want to call it. It makes people disappear.
No, no way.
I'm not lying! I'm not lying. And if you've been hearing the whispers for days, then the book wants you.
No, you can't know that. You don't know that, not for sure.
Yes, I do. Look, be careful. Come back in a few days when the store isn't so busy. We can talk then.
Get the eggs?
Oh, shoot. Forgot them.
But I did stop by that weird bookstore we saw.
Did you see that kid? Did he tell you to be careful?
No, but he did have some odd things to say.
Odd how?
Like, he told me this weird campfire story about a dumb book.
Are you kidding me, Rachel? The book again.
Well, it sounded a whole lot like our book, so I thought it might be important to listen to.
How many times do I have to tell you? We're fine. Yeah, it sucks. We can't chill in our dorm rooms anymore, but we're grown-ups now.
That's not it. The kid says that this book traps souls and has for hundreds of years.
Wow, Rach, you always have to be the smart one.
I'm not. I just think we should leave the book alone.
That's so stupid.
Please. For me.
Fine, I'll leave it alone. Nice fruit. Got any plans today?
Nope, just relaxing. You?
Nothing yet. Might follow your lead and have a lax day, too.
Well, you deserve it.
We can't argue, though. Every day in this town is a lax day.
I thought you were starting to like it here.
I miss home.
I don't. I like being an adult.
You're literally afraid to answer the door, Rachel.
Hey, I'm trying my best.
Admit it. You want to go home, too.
I'm sure once school starts in the fall, it'll be much better.
It was so stupid of us to come here.
You just hate living with me.
I don't hate living with you. I hate how crazy you've become lately.
Delilah, what did you do?
What do you mean?
My painting. You ruined it.
I didn't do that.
Yes, you did. Who else could have?
Not me.
I can't stand you.
I can't believe you.
You may be the one thing in this town that's not deathly boring.
Where are you headed?
Bethel, New York. They're having this big outdoor festival. Everyone's gonna be there. Hendrix, Janis Joplin, Grateful Dead.
You had me at New York. Hop in.
Groovy.
My name's Ronnie, by the way.
I'm Hazel.
Your parents didn't name you that.
How'd you know?
Most runaways usually change their name the first chance they get.
Yeah.
I've been all over.
Like where?
Lake of the Ozarks. Salt Lake City, Key West, Detroit, everywhere.
Wow.
That's what all the stuff in the back is. I try to get a little something from every place I roam.
What about this?
It's a book. Got it in California. Haven't looked through it yet, to be honest. I'm not much of a reader.
It's empty.
Weird. Sorry, this thing's a hunk of junk. Let me make sure we're not about to explode.
Excuse me, is James here today?
What do you want with James?
I just want to talk to him.
What, are you his friend or something?
Is he here?
Oh, Rachel, hey. Hey, I hope you're here to buy some books because he's got a lot of work to do.
Yeah, Rachel came in yesterday for the biography sale, and she forgot her wallet, so I'm here to help her find some stuff.
We'll get back to work.
Yes, sir.
Sorry about my dad. He's not used to me having a social life.
That was your dad?
Yeah. How are things at home?
awful. Me and Delilah keep fighting, and she's just not herself anymore. And I stopped hearing the voices, but it still feels off.
Maybe the book doesn't want you anymore.
That's good, right?
Well, it depends on how you look at it. The book needs a certain number of souls before the author is released, and maybe it doesn't need yours anymore.
It doesn't need me anymore?
Maybe it only needs Delilah.
Then how do you know?
Rachel, I have secrets. Big secrets. Secrets that, if I tell anyone, I start to sound crazy.
Well, I already feel like I'm going crazy.
Okay. Well, the stuff in your house, it's mine.
What?
I used to live there with my dad and my mom.
So all those things, the book, they're yours?
When I was little, the book was donated to the bookstore. And my dad brought it home to show us, and things got strange.
You can tell me, James.
My mom disappeared. We don't know where. My dad and I told people that she moved to New York. That was a lie. It has to have been the book.
Oh my God.
You need to get out of that house, away from that book.
You need to get out.
What? So now you're kicking me out?
That's not what I'm saying.
You know, I think you're the one who needs to leave.
It's not about you or me, Delilah. It's just not safe.
You're so paranoid.
Okay, well, what's behind your back? I thought you said you weren't gonna touch the book anymore. Have you been messing with it this whole time?
Yes.
What don't you get? This is dangerous!
Oh, Hunter, you scared me.
Sorry, Miss Abigail. Just thought I'd check in on the school tonight.
The schoolhouse is doing just fine. Thank you for stopping by.
Wait, can we continue my lessons? I just need to learn to read. I have to learn how to read. I just have to.
All right, but just for a little while.
Well, I found this odd book at the trading post that had these magical words in it that appeared in thin air.
Well, first of all, it's in Latin.
Well, what's it say?
My Lord, O is great. You will protect me from evil and grant me the power of the night, need to survive.
It's a Bible, then.
I don't think so. Leonard, I think you should go.
No, wait. Do you speak Latin?
A little. At university, we mostly just did written translations.
Can you try? Please?
All right. Domine mi magnus protegas, mi ab his malis, da mihi protestatum notus opus superi.
To talk. I wanted to apologize. I mean, what if you're right and this is all in our heads? But some crazy things have been happening, and I just, what if it's a wake-up call to the real issue? What if we're not ready to be on our own yet? I don't know how I feel about this, Dee. I think we should just consider our options. And we can move out if you want. You know, never talk about that dumb book ever again. So, what do you say? Delilah?
Domine me! Magnus protegas me abis malus. Da mihi protestatum noctis opus aggressit.
Pray pardon me. Well done, my child. Fare thee well. Corporeal at last, after all these years. Not a single hair out of place.
It's been a long time coming. I'm glad you're here.
But we gotta be careful. You're out of your element. We gotta keep you out of sight.
Out of sight? I am no coward, dear George. What else is there to do but enjoy oneself?
But we gotta keep the book and you safe.
I am perfectly capable of holding my own self accountable. The book is of no consequence.
But it's still very powerful, and it's actually upset that you left.
The book won't turn on me, you addle plot. That's what you imply.
Well, it's angry, and it could.
It shan't! I am so much more cowing than some leather-bound stack of pulp. You will find no fear in my heart.
James? James, hello? James! James!
Delilah, what's the matter with you?
The book! Rachel, it took...
The
Please
book
help.
Rachel?
She told me not to touch it. I didn't listen. God, I'm an idiot!
You're not an idiot.
I couldn't stop it. I tried.
We can fix this. We can fix this.
How? How?
There is one thing.
What?
There is a secret section in the bookstore. My dad's into some pretty dark magic. It's forbidden. We should check there.
Let's go.
Many score have passed since my trial and its verdict. Want to thank you for your contribution those many years past. Really aided me in my time trapped.
When can I see her?
What? See her? Have you honestly held out hope all these years that she would be returned to you? You have hoped in vain, dear boy.
Of course. My mistake.
Have joy, George. If it weren't for her, you wouldn't even be alive. Well, she saved your life. Be thankful. It will be worth it in the end, I promise you. There are no judges or jurors with the power to stop me. Now I am free to do whatever I am so inclined to do.
Well, listen to me. Lay low. It may not be as threatening to your time, but the same superstition lives on.
Sheep often fear what they do not understand, what they could not possibly comprehend. They need not comprehend in any case. All I require from a person is their soul.
We'll keep you and the book separate. But please, don't go back to the house of those poor girls. Trust me.
And deprive me of my hunting? The book can stay. I, however, shall be taking my leave. I want to thank you again for your servitude.
I don't like the look of this.
We have to do this for Rachel. I've seen inside that book. I know what it can do.
What did you see?
Every person the book has ever taken. They would touch the book, it would choose them, and then it would force them to read one of their chants in Latin.
It has the power to do all of that?
And more. I never told Rachel, but at night it would call out to me too. It told me its name, what it wanted to be called.
We have to put an end to this. Where is that word again?
Here.
Here?
And on this first page. And on this one.
This one too. That must be.
And it's in the book.
It's right here.
James. James, what's wrong? James, are you okay?
George, I think we should talk about moving.
Moving? We've lived here for years. I mean, the store's doing well. We just had a baby. We're not fit to move.
The house feels different now.
Well, we can't just leave.
You can't, but I can.
So you would leave our son?
I would take him with me. The house, it isn't safe.
You can't do that.
I'm sorry, George.
James. James, I'm so sorry.
That traitor. He lied to me. For years!
I don't know what to say.
The author may have thought that this would stop us, but he actually just gave us the answer.
What's that?
A soul for a soul.
Like a trade?
Exactly. We'll trade my soul for
no.
Rachel's.
No, I started this. We'll trade mine.
No, Delilah, Rachel needs you.
I started this. I must be the one to fix it.
All right, but we need to go now.
We can go over there. Okay, I'm ready.
You're doing a brave thing, Delilah.
Anything for Rachel.
Well, well, well.
Graves.
Yes, me. And you, Delilah, my favorite servant. What great work you did with your friend.
Don't listen to him, Delilah.
Oh, how you worried her. Lashing out and being so unreasonable. She was just trying to help you. Why didn't you let her?
Delilah, don't listen to him. Start the spell.
Do be quiet, boy. Lest you end up like your mother!
James!
Look at the both of you, scrambling to banish me back in the book. Who do you suppose created it in the first place?
I did.
To think I would allow such an insult to pass.
You're both more stupid than I thought.
Graves! What are you doing to my son?
Dad? It's time to make things right.
I know what happened to Mom.
Yeah, and I regret it every day, James. Every day.
Enough of this!
I agree!
Dad, what are you doing?
I'm gonna make things right. I love you, son.
You're gonna make touch the wrong cure, Mama. We did it, Jeff! No!
Delilah? Rachel! Oh my god, Rachel!
You're coming out.
I'm sorry. I'm so, so sorry.
We're safe. That's all that matters.
James?
Huh?
I wasn't alone in there.
Mom? But how? How did the spell free you?
A soul for a soul. Well, in this case, too. Your father may have betrayed us, but today he saved me. And Graves isn't in power of the book anymore.
I want to go home, Delilah.
Me too, Rachel. Me too.
Awesome. We can get out of here, finally.
I wanted to say goodbye before you left.
We'll miss you, James.
I can't thank you enough. If it weren't for you two, I wouldn't have my mom back.
You saved us too, James. We need to deal with this.